Today I'm at beautiful Markham Park. I'm gonna do a little bit of camping tonight. I'm here super early today to get set up my tent, which I've never really done before, so that should be comedy right there. It's about 10 o'clock in the morning. Check-in is actually at around 3, but because this is a weekday and it's not really busy, nobody had our campsite from the night before, so they went ahead and told us we can set up whenever we want, and I'm gonna do that right now. The spot I'm looking for is Circle K. It's a beautiful spot. It was highly recommended by the lady that works in the office here at Markham Park. It's near the canal, so there's a nice view. And also, if it rains, the water kind of runs off. It's not gonna really flood here in this spot like I guess it might in other spots. She said she learned that the hard way. So I took her advice and looks good. Through the course of this video, you will hear gunshots. There is a firing range right over here. So every now and then you hear a lot of gunshots. The police actually practice there as well, so they use some pretty heavy stuff over there. All right, so let's get down to business. Okay, this is my cooler, which contains ice, obviously. Also, it has a package of hot dogs and a sub sandwich. In this backpack, I have 2 frozen jugs of water, so as the day goes on and they thaw out, I'll have cold water throughout the day. This is my tent, which I got for Christmas and have been dying to try that out, so we'll see how that goes. There's my camera bag. These are a couple of lanterns. Actually, we got like a dozen of these. We used them for one of the kids' parties. One of them I actually dropped this morning on the way to the car. You can see a crack in that, and the bulb came loose. But whatever, it still lights up, so it's good enough for camping. This is from the dollar store. Not 100% sure that we'll use it. It's just to throw some burgers or hot dogs on when we use the grill. Depending on how disgusting the grill is, but it looks okay, so we may or may not use that. But also from the dollar store, I got a couple of these LED lamps to kind of light our way if we have to go to the restroom in the middle of the night. And this is an inflatable mattress in lieu of a nice sleeping bag. It's got the little motor. That's the mattress. In that box right there is an electrical outlet so I can inflate it. And this would be That would be Lynden right there to join me. The important thing to remember, if you've never set up a tent before, don't throw away the instructions, which I did. Don't you think that's valuable information?
It's still here.
Because that's what I did. If I can't even open this, what are my chances that I'll be able to set up a tent? I'm already in a scrape. Basically, I'm going by the picture. That's what I've got to work with. It should be fine.
I mean, this is technically a two-person job, but I'm just curious. If I were to ever try to do this on my own, what are the chances that I could make that happen? I feel like I should have run this through something first.
No, it's just a flag,
actually. Oh, no, it should have ran through that. That was probably a very important step. So far, so good?
Yeah.
Of course, it's turning into a sail right now. All right, that wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. I hope the air mattress fits in there. It's a full size.
My instructions are attached to my bag, so I won't throw mine away. It says, number one, choose a suitable site to pitch your tent. A good site should be flat, proper drainage from rain water. Remove sharp objects. Assemble the two poles. This is
you just got a two-person tent, or what?
No, it's a four-person tent.
Well, there you go.
Because I get claustrophobic. Two people tents, too small. I don't know how they expect two people to live in a tent. Unless you're jammed up like jellyfish. Like sardines, actually. Okay, number two. The rest of you want to read?
Which one are you on?
Number two.
Oh. Alrighty. Lay the assembled poles on top of the tent. Start placing the pole tips into the grommets located at the tent corners until all four pole ends are in place and the poles form a dome over the tent. So pretty much more or less what I just did. Good morning, everybody. Lyndon just joined us. He parachuted in, and he's folding up his parachute now.
The one on the other side, too, or just one each?
Both poles. So I guess...
There
goes mine.
And that's what happens when you don't stake yours before you start building the next tent. Okay, so number three, attach the clips on the tent around the tent poles to assemble the tent.
Okay, clips. So yeah, one person can do it. Really easy.
We have trash blowing around. Pick it up. Don't leave it out here. All right, I'm going to leave you to your tent for a minute. I think mine needs some help here. Oh, mine has clips too. I don't know why I didn't clip mine.
Yep. Grab one coin.
Jump for the tree here. Again, I'm going by the picture. That's the second time I should have learned to go ahead and stake the tent. For the love of God, I need to hurry up and do that now. The only thing I didn't bring was something to hammer the stakes into the ground with. I'd have to look. It's possible I might have something.
Yeah. This is the car.
God's sake, that looks.
Again, I'm going by the picture here. Aren't these people happy? There's like, even ducks are hanging out with them. I don't see no ducks. All right, so this thing kind of like sticks out. So I guess that's, I feel like I'm gonna snap this thing, but I guess I'm not. I guess that's how I, yeah, there we go. Ah, crap. I was tying this one down and I snapped the little loop here off. I was never in the Boy Scouts, so this isn't a good knot. Whatever. This goes. All right, the pump doesn't work. It's not plugged in. Sweet digs.
Walk in and take a look.
Very nice. You have plenty of room for you and all the raccoons that want to join us later. That big fella right there is an iguana staying in the tree, which just so happens to put him right above my tent. So hopefully he stays up there. He doesn't come crashing down at some point. Thank you. All right, here's my setup. I was charging my camera in here earlier, so that's why this is here. These are just some sheets from home. A little pillow. Some shorts to throw on later when I want to get comfy. But let's kick my shoes off. Let's see how this tent feels. Ugh.
As usual, I overpack.
Jesus. I thought I was going bad. You're bringing up.
So this is what the camping experience is all about.
Knock, knock.
It's warm in here. Alright. Trying to undo my sleeping bag. See the pad?
Now that's fully inflated, or is
yeah,
it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, I was expecting a little bit
bigger.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it gives you something.
Yeah, right? Wow, this is my view. Couldn't want better.
Backing away slowly now. Backing away slowly. So if you remember our view from the tent, you could see that long ridge wall. I keep calling it a ridge. I don't know if that's what you would actually call it, but on top of it, there's a bike path. You're about to see that right now. Just so happy right now. Happy to be alive.
Up.
There we go. So Lyndon and I are trying to give ourselves like third degree burns because we didn't bring any forks or anything to flip these things. So we're doing it kind of with our fingers. Don't try this at home.
Ow. Ouch.
How's it taste?
Gourmet.
And also in our infinite wisdom, we forgot to bring plates or anything, so we're doing everything by hand here. These little lights are working to a certain extent, but it's still pretty dark out here, as you can see. That's our fire. So we are just making an ever-loving mess. Mm. Mm. That's good.
He's just shoving it in your mouth right
on you. Well, it sounds like the shooting range finally closed, so that's a good thing. Not that I mind people exercising their Second Amendment rights, but come on, this is getting a little ridiculous here at night. All right, Lyndon, so I want to hear a ghost story. I'm going to hold the light up to your face like that.
I can't see.
Come on.
I can't see. I'm going to bust my ass.
You know, that's not a very scary ghost story. I feel gypped. Is this the trash can up here?
Yeah.
We're over here by the restroom and shower area. I'm gonna throw our trash away, make sure the raccoons don't pay us a visit tonight. Well, it's been a pretty great day. Now it's gonna be a pretty good night. Just listening to nothing but crickets and airplanes. Good morning, sir.
Morning.
How was it?
Excellent. I feel refreshed, revived, renewed, and relieved.
I was pretty comfortable last night, but I can't really say that I slept all that well. And it wasn't because I didn't enjoy the spot I was in, or I have that same problem in motel rooms where if I'm in a new place, I just can't fall asleep right away. Or if I do, I can't stay asleep. But I didn't mind waking up because there was crickets just all night long. There was a bullfrog or something near the tent, and I enjoy listening to him. And the occasional jumbo jet, but that's okay. I expect that. It's South Florida. There's an international airport about 5 miles from here. So the hardest part is leaving. Lyndon, any final words about our camping experience? Anything you do differently next time, or?
Just come a little bit more prepared when it comes to utensils and stuff like that. But you live and learn. Just make an extensive list. Otherwise, I had a good time.
Anything that we did right?
Get out here.
There you go. That's all it took.